My name is Omar. Omar English.
What's your favorite color?
Blue.
Favorite animal?
Lion.
Favorite superhero?
Superman.
Why?
Superman, because like he got superpowers. Like.
What made you first get into film?
Well, funny story. I was at school one day. And then I was like, I saw this poster on the wall and it said something about like filmmaking, like summertime, big picture lines. So I looked into it, and I wasn't in the right grade at the time to be able to do it. But they like still let me come. So when I came, I was just liking it. And then I made this one film called like True Dream Chasing. And then after that, like I really just started liking it. Like, started liking filmmaking.
What age was it when you first decided to make film?
Well, I was 12, about to be there, going on 13. When I was about to become like started filming basically.
Tell us about your life.
Well, I was born May 11, 2000. I lost my mom at the age of nine. My dad, he got incarcerated when I was nine also. And then I went to go live with my grandma. That's about it. Everything else.
Where are you from?
I'm from Uptown Philadelphia.
What's your neighborhood like?
I mean, my neighborhood quiet. Like, everybody got a neighbor. Like, everybody live in neighborhoods. Like, they're not perfect. Like, my neighborhood quiet. But, like, stuff still happen. Like, people still get robbed. Like, people still get shot. Like, but it rarely happens. Like in some parts, like Southwest, all that, like, new people, like, get killed or did stuff like that. It don't happen. But, like, stuff bad. I'm not going. Like, stuff bad still happen on my way.
So besides filming, like what else are you into?
I like, of course, video games, playing 2K. I like just like helping people. I like reading. Helping people. I'm just like a caring person. I like reading. But like only like reading like real stories. I don't like reading enough. And I like reading Sports Illustrated.
So besides Sports Illustrated, what else do you read? Do you have a certain genre or?
No, I don't really have a certain genre.
You just like go to a library and pick out any book and you just read it.
Mm-hmm.
What are you passionate about?
I'm passionate about filmmaking. I'm just passionate about like just creating visual stuff that people like see like my ideas that's inside my head.
What do you see yourself doing in the future with
them? Making like a lot of big films, like meaningful films, and just like making films that can hopefully one day be in the pearl. My ideas for my films just come from like stuff that I see, personal events, stuff around me, stuff in my community. Something like my favorite director, Spike Lee, did. I just like try to like implement it and break it down from like people like in my generation to like where they can understand it or something like that.
So for people who like view your films and stuff, like what is the message that you want to get out? Is there one?
Well, it's not really a message. Like it depends on what I'm talking about in my film. Like my recent film I made is called Shame. I was talking about like a girl who gets slut shamed by her boyfriend or not. So like that was basically like saying like slut shame is not cool, bullying not cool. Like it was around that genre. It was just getting off a mess of like slut shame and not cool. Like she basically like sent her boyfriend a nude and then like he got her on the school, stuff like that.
So do all your films have messages or just a handful?
A handful.
What do you want your viewers to like get from you? Like
I just want them to get like even like most of my I just want them like to get like just to get like something from like each film. It's like my last film, I just wanted people like to realize like slut shaming wasn't cool. Then the film before that, it's called Lost and Found. I just wanted people to realize that like trying something new is always good, even if you don't like really want to try it. It's always good to at least try, give an effort.
Who are your idols?
I don't really have an idol. I look up to a boy in our city called Chop Mosley. I look up to Spike Lee.
Why?
Cause like, all right, so Chop, he like, it's like, I saw when his film like really started like from the bottom, like, so I saw him did because it was in one of his interviews or whatever. But like, he basically like worked hard. Like, you see the progression from where he started from the bottom to now, like, his they look amazing. And then Spike Lee, he just always been my like favorite director. Like, very, like my favorite films like Do the Right Thing. On his old films, he's gotta have it. And, he made like a lot of Michael Jackson films.